Why, hello, and welcome to the mailroom, where you can watch Sierra steal garbage out of the trash bag. This is all the mail that came in during the time that I was gone on my short little weekend. I was away for, I think, 4 days of mail, and this much mail came in. Holy cow. But, it's always a good thing. It's a good thing to have too much rather than not enough. So I called in Christy, and she came over to help. Bless her heart. She's one of my regular volunteers who comes over quite often, so she knows how to unpack mail. There are times when I just set her loose on unpacking while I'm working on videos on the other side of the room. But today we're working on it together. My tables have been lent out to somebody else, so we're just working on the counter. But I wanted to help you to watch the big pile dwindle down as I chit-chat with you. The packages that we're opening first are the small ones. We open those because they're usually more painful, a lot more work to do in just everything that has to be done with a package for just 6 cards is the same thing that we have to do for a package that has 300 cards in it. So we like the bigger ones better. They tend to just be a little easier process. So we get the little ones done first, get all of them finished. And you see me going over to that section on the right-hand side, that is the card hospital. So there are cards that we put over there, depending on whether sometimes we see some buttons in there that are too thick and so we need to go through them more, or we see a card or two with glitter, or there's, you know, just other things that we need to deal with. So we put them over there in that section and save them for another time. One of the things that Christy noticed, which I thought was very observant, and I was really happy to see that she noticed this too, because I always wonder if it's just me, is that during this time that we're opening these boxes right now, the quality of the cards was like amazingly better than during the time when we get cards around holidays. Because around the holiday season, whatever holiday it is, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Christmas, whatever, we get a lot of folks who just want to help out for a holiday and they throw stuff together. So all of you who are giving us cards right now, bless you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for doing cards in the middle of the year when everybody else doesn't want to do it. And you guys rock. You're our rock star, amazing card makers. And we just really appreciate that you continue this support through rain or shine, holiday or no holiday. Let's take a little Sierra break and see what she's doing while we're doing all this work. Yeah, that's my girl. She just likes to take a little nap. She's got the smart part of the job. She gets to just take a little rest while we work hard. We're about halfway through. We're getting to the medium boxes now and starting to open all of those guys. Our shelves above us are getting fuller, and the empties that we've been pulling from are getting full. We're gonna have to actually start keeping some of them in flat rate boxes for the moment, because we don't have enough of the little black boxes to put them in. So it's a little overwhelming, the amount of mail. Excellent, excellent job to everyone who's sending them in. As we're going, we're checking a lot of things. We check every single time we open a box, we check to see if they're tucked. You know, we pull out some random ones, we pull out a few to see if they're stamped, and then we just assume that the rest of them are. So we hope that you don't just stamp the one that we pick out and not the rest of them. Working our way down, and Sierra just keeps getting up to monitor what we're doing and check us out, because she is supervisor extraordinaire. One of the other things that Christy noticed in this batch as well, that she said a couple times, and I'll just throw that out there for you, is how much you can tell the difference between heavier cardstock and not heavy cardstock. And I know you can't tell through the magic of YouTube what that difference is, but it really is amazing when you hold a card, you touch a card that has been made with, you know, good cardstock and layers and stuff, and then one that just was on designer paper or on that really thin cardstock, that kind of stuff. The difference is night and day. And so you can really tell kind of between the two. So if you ever wonder why I emphasize that, it really does make a difference. And I know when our heroes go through the box too, it would make a difference when they're looking through, because they're seeing the same thing I'm seeing. They're seeing one of every different card, and you can tell when one has a whole lot more put into it, and then one just has a sticker tossed onto it, that kind of thing. So there's that one big box, the big box that's covered in paper that we have been putting aside. We have not been getting to it yet. We found that big boxes can either be huge boxes full of gorgeous, gorgeous cards, or they can be a hot mess that we have to really do a lot of work to. So we've saved this one because we're frightened. Sometimes that happens, but this time I have to say we were blessed. These were beautiful, beautiful, beautiful cards. I think it was a Stampin' Up! Gal who sent them in. I don't even remember right now whose it was, but I have a little helpful tidbit that I wanted to give to all of you, because we have a lot of people who send in big boxes like that one, and that is to send them in smaller boxes instead of one giant box. This one would have, if it was broken down into smaller amounts, it would have actually arrived in better condition. They were all in one, and you can see me taking this giant handful of cards that are all stuck together because they slid down the side into each other. Even though you put one little piece of paper across the layers, they still slide down around the edges of it, and so we had a whole bunch of cards that landed in triage. So please do break it down into smaller boxes. It'll be cheaper for you, as well as they'll arrive in better condition. I hope this has been an interesting mailroom episode for you. I have behind me the boxes I turned all that into, so they're all packed and ready to go. And Nancy's going to be here tomorrow with a video, so stay tuned for that one. See you guys later. Bye now.